conventional from the start. US President Donald Trump's stance on Pyongyang has been in stark contrast with previous administrations. His apparent admiration for Kim Jong-un was a surprise early turn.
He's dealing with obviously very tough people, in particular the generals and others. So obviously he's a pretty smart cookie.
But as Pyongyang pursued long-range missile testing, Trump's attitude changed radically.
The United States has great strength and patience. But if it is forced to defend itself or its allies, we will have no choice but to totally destroy North Korea. Rocket Man is on a suicide mission for himself and for his regime.
The following months saw a war of words, at times aggressive, at times bizarre. Kim Jong-un responded to Trump's tweets with his own barb, calling him a dotard. The US president shot back, insinuating that the North Korean leader was short and fat. In January this year, he boasted to the world that his nuclear button was bigger and more powerful than Kim Jong-un's. But despite the verbal tit-for-tat, Trump's administration also began to take a more conciliatory approach. A key factor was South Korean President Moon Jae-in, elected to office last year. In March this year, South Korean envoys announced that the North had shown a willingness to denuclearize. Hours later, Trump confirmed the news on his favorite platform, Twitter, adding that a meeting was in the works. Things then took another unexpected turn when U.S. National Security Advisor John Bolton went on Fox News and compared Pyongyang to Libya. An awkward message. Libya gave up its nuclear program in return for concessions, but Libyan dictator Colonel Gaddafi was eventually killed. The North Koreans reacted furiously, threatening to cancel the summit. Trump himself went one step further and called it off the next day.
I believe that this is a tremendous setback for North Korea and indeed a setback for the world.
But there would be yet another twist. On June the 1st, Trump changed his mind once again and confirmed that the meeting was back on.